So as far back as I can remember, it was about 5 years old, coming in to visit with Grandpa. Fast forward, I could see that it was this place where everybody just came together. Rumor has it that my grandfather was very well known and respected by some mob guys and the community because of who he knew. Grandpa wasn't one to talk too much though, so he would listen to your stories, but wouldn't go home and say anything. So even to the day when he got sick and I'd sit there and ask him questions, he'd act like he didn't hear me. And I'd say, listen here, old man, I know you can hear what I'm saying to you. A lot of the secrets that he had, he actually took to the grave with him, which is why I assume they took a liking to him, because he didn't turn around and tell stories. At the time, in 74, when my grandfather actually came, he met Jackie Gaughan, who was the owner of the El Cortez at the time, and well, he has his ties and whatnot, with another gentleman named, goes by the name Tiger. He shook his hand, shook my grandfather's hand after they talked. There was no paper contract, nothing like that. He just shook his hand and said, now go make a million. I was always in the barbershop from a very, very young age up until middle school. I would actually go sweep up my uncle's barbershop, and there I got paid for it, like 10 bucks a barber. So every Saturday as a little fat kid, sweeping up the floor, it was great, you know. I ran, I got lunch for everybody, I got free lunch, you know, it was great. It's all about the experience. I compare getting a haircut like buying a white t-shirt at the mall. You can go to any store that you want to get a white t-shirt. Same thing with a haircut, you can go to any barbershop to get a regular haircut, but it's the experience and the way you feel when you walk into this environment and really just get off your feet. I just love how Vegas came up from the start, you know, just everything, the history about Las Vegas. But honestly, those ties aren't what drew me. What drew me was these are the floors that I used to sweep up as a little boy. So when I found out that Grandpa's shop was now available, because it wasn't so much like, oh, I'm gonna go back downtown, it was I'm going back home to Grandpa's barbershop. The flooring is getting torn up in the barber area with being held down by some screws and nails. And
oh, it was rough. I'm so
miserable. We don't know.
I'm kidding.
One thing led to another where it was like, we gotta do that. Well, we gotta do this, we gotta do that. So a starting project of X amount turned into a whole thing, and that's where Heather and Vincent really came in and saved my life.
Awesome. I got a phone call. I'm sitting on the couch and he says, I finally got the barbershop I've been looking for. And I say, great, send me pictures.
She didn't know what she was getting into.
This was once a hotel room. And so this hotel room was maybe renovated once in the 70s and never touched again. I wanted you to walk in and really just feel like you walked into the past. You're in this historic building, you're in this fantastic corner of, you know, the Las Vegas downtown area. Mm-hmm. It should feel that way.
Well, I think we wanted to go for a mix of like modern and old world, so a really traditional style wallpaper, but adding elements of the barbershop, the face, the knives and the signs. If you look at this picture, you can see the top window is actually the barbershop, so we lit that up, so it's like there's someone in there, so we just wanted that sort of element.
Yeah, this is the exact image of what's outside.
Yeah, and then, you know, with a fun mix of stuff from his grandfather, like the register and the old barber sign.
We're really set apart because we are from Vegas. We're not just outsiders coming in, so we love the environment. We're actually a part of the community. So that alone and the experience, it's words aren't going to be able to tell you or make you feel that way until you come in and experience it yourself.